Hello, and welcome to another ASMR video. A third one. So exciting. I finally have to work with on my mic now. Very exciting. But tonight I am going to do a little roleplay. We'll start in a second. I'll do a dramatic something to show you. So much to me that you clicked on this video and that you're still here listening to me ramble. Oh my goodness. I can't thank you enough. So, thank you so much. And I hope you enjoy. Yes. Hello. Thank you. Okay. So, we'll just take a look at some of these before we catalog it. So we have a classic shell Silverstein. Poems and drawings of Shel Silverstein. Oh, yes. Very classic. Have you read Shel Silverstein? Please tell me you've read Shel Silverstein. This is comic book about Avatar, The Last Airbender. It's called The Search. Yes, and it's about the biggest mystery of the Avatar, The Last Airbender animated series. The fate of Fire Lord Zuko's mother is revealed when Zuko discovers a clue to Ursa's fate. Before I forget, I'm going to give you some tea so you can calm down, right? Because you're a little hyper, okay? And this tea is peppermint tea, which is good for the nervous system. You don't know what kind of things I write in my journal, but you want to know. It's weird. For your information, it looks a little something like this. So, chew on that. And there's also a lot of lists. There's a lot of bad art. You know how it feels to a cell.
Yeah.
I don't know why you want it inside my journal. I don't think as a librarian I had any reason to show it to you other than the kindness of my heart. You're not seeing this one. This one's from 2019. No. No. Nobody is really himself when he is not in love. I got this one from a bookshop, but I'm still gonna give it to you. I'm still gonna give it to you because you need to read it. It's three of the classic pieces of short fiction of the man who wrote, of course, Brave New World. Please tell me you've read Brave New World. Okay. No? Well, again, like the Avatar book. Maybe this will be enough to encourage you to read Brave New World. If you like any of these three, would you like me to check this out for you? Would you like me to write this one down? Okay, I'll put this with your stuff. Okay. So I know that I gave it to you, and I can't give it to someone else.
After the fireworks.
Yeah, okay. It's yours now. It's all yours. All yours, buddy. All yours. Yeah.
So glad you brought this
to me. Yeah. The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Mm-hmm.
Oh, little drawings in there. Little doodles. Well, not doodles. I mean, somebody really went and drew those. But they're not usually the whole page. Oh, that's great.
Children's book format and see the movie, but this is a really good addition. you find yourself longing for words you don't know, but you need to describe feelings that you've never described before, then this book is for you.
This book is full of words that you vaguely heard before, but you definitely couldn't define if somebody asked you the definition. I love really retaining words like that, so.
Did you want to expand your vocabulary or remain a dunce? Because that's, you know, it's up to you. It's between you and God, but...
You don't want to check this one out? You're not interested in being a nerd? Okay, that's fine.
By Emily Dickinson. Not in vain. If I can stop one heart from breaking, I shall not live in vain. If I can ease one life the aching, or cool one pain, or help one fighting robin unto his nest again, I shall not. Here's one. The Night Has a Thousand Eyes by Francis William Bourdillon. The night has a thousand eyes, and the day but one.
Yet the light of the bright world dies with the dying sun. The mind has 1,000 eyes and the heart but one. Yet the light of a whole life dies when love is done. See, them 1800s poems be hitting sometimes. Would you like to check this out? Slight trigger warning. Talk of suicide. Okay. So, I won't bore you with the details of my mental health. But I know that you've been struggling. Not terribly, but badly, as one does. When I can assume ASMR. So, I got you this light reading. You don't have to take it super seriously, but it is a little bit literal. It's called something that you know is going to hurt yourself later on. And you're thinking, I know that that's not the right idea, but I can't think of a way to cope. And sometimes reading therapistaid.com materials feel like too much coping as it is. You know what I mean? So sometimes looking at a book this silly can help you feel a little bit more inspired to think of something else to do. Because, I tell you what, I have used it in dire moments of need. I have gotten tattoos because one of the pages, I don't know if I'll find it. I would have to look pretty far. One of them is getting tattooed. This one says, write a joke. I have done that because of this book before. Yeah. This one says, drink a ton of energy drinks and then do nothing. That's great. The other page says, join a cult. Film a claymation porno. Make food for two, just in case. Okay, it's kind of a sad book. I did it. Mail a letter to yourself. Get a manicure. get a minimum wage job, sew a sweater with a sad face on it, edit the word shit on the woman's Wikipedia page, tell other people what's wrong with them. Get into a shitty relationship. See, there's all kinds of pastimes that this book has to suggest for you. And you can try it. You can give it a shot. Would you like? Would you like to take this home with you?
Would you like to take this home?
Find someone who is doing worse than you and befriend them. Write someone a love letter, then burn it. Yeah. All great ideas. I think you should give this book a shot, whether or not. Okay. Yeah. You're willing? Okay. Okay. That was by Tara Booth and John. You're such a music stand, you know. What kind of insult is that? What does that even mean? You just hold my music for me. Or you push over, is that what that means? Are you patient? That's almost a compliment. That you're sturdy and responsible. You are sturdy and responsible for watching my video all the way through. If you did, I'm so fucking thankful for you. You have no idea, actually.
Obviously, monetization. And I'm gonna just plea for advice. I think I made this account wrong because I did it with my school account, and I don't know if I can turn on two-factor authentication. So, will I be able to monetize my account? Can I have some help, please? I need an expert's advice. So,
let me know in the comments.
any triggers that you want. If you prefer my sing-songy to my whisper to my soft-spoken, just let me know. Even my soft-spoken, my normal voice is a little tonal. Just let me know your thoughts. And thank you so much for watching. Yes! I will see you in the next video.